What's up, everybody? It's Keith Allen, and welcome to this analysis of Liquid Poach. Poach, he's a Fortnite superstar, plain and simple. The man is all business. He's cool, he's always calm, and he's collected. The reason why he wins almost all the time is because of his incredible game sense. In this video, I'm gonna break down how Poach uses his offense and defense to get out of sticky situations and how he almost wins every fight. After this video, you'll be one step closer to playing just like Poach. You ready? Let's do it.
Poach is in a solo versus squad game, and its loadout has all the essentials with the heavy AR, pump shotgun, and SMG. In this clip, we're gonna watch Poach make all the right moves in a 1v3 situation. Copy exactly what Poach does here to give yourself a chance at clutching a squad win for your team. Here, he spots out a player and decides not to take any shots just yet. This was a great decision. Instead, he gets even better position that allows him to fire multiple shots, and he ends up securing the kill with some sick headshots. He traps this player in a cone and is off to fight again. He's able to land a pop shot, and instead of taking the bloom fight that an average player would take, he makes the right play and he builds for high ground. So you guys might be asking, why did Poach win the ramp push but build the other way? You guys might have not seen it, but right as he ramp pushes there, another player is to his left. He recognizes this without even turning his camera. Whenever you're in a situation where you're outnumbered, you must prioritize high ground. Once you lose high ground in a 1v2, you're done for, and that's why Poach turned around. Right when he secures high ground, he goes into attack mode. He sees one of his opponents under him and quickly edits his ramp and floor and nails his opponent for kill number two. This edit is extremely useful for any of you guys that are struggling to win fights despite having high ground. Now, it's just 1v1, and you already know how the story ends. Poach pulls out his SMG, and the rest is history. In this example, you saw Poach display discipline by not taking the first available shot, and instead, he gets better position. He also performed a great edit from high ground to surprise the enemy. Most importantly, he showed his amazing situational awareness by prioritizing high ground and the 1v2. Now you know a few more ways to impress your friends and clutch out a win solo versus squads. Here, Poach is in a solo game with a very nice loadout. He has a heavy AR, shotgun, and SMG. In this clip, we're going to examine how Poach plays the low ground and how he's able to beat not just one, but two players from inside the same box. After watching this clip, you'll have a better idea of how to win from an unfavorable position. Poach sees a freshly built wooden ramp and goes into instant high ground mode. I point this out in every single analysis video, and I'm going to keep doing it until every one of you guys are using this technique. Whenever you're ramp pushing, build a second ramp to the side. You cover so much ground, you deny your enemies from high ground, and it's just better in every single way. Once Poach gains high ground, he gives it up because he's Poach and he goes for the kill. He tries for a no-scope shot, and 99% of the time, I say don't do it. But if you're that close, your chances aren't that bad. Poach quickly identifies that his own buildings are holding up his opponent's high ground. Destroying the base of the structure is always a solid choice whenever you're playing low ground. Poach chooses to edit instead of using his pickaxe or gun because editing makes significantly less sound. Poach is caught in the act of breaking the structure and is forced into a defensive box. Despite turbo building, Poach gets hit by two SMG shots. He could have prevented any damage by building a ramp, but he chose to play offensively instead, which is fine. His opponent eventually slips through Poach's wall, and it's an all-in fight from here. Even though Poach comes out on top, this is always a scary situation. Poach isn't finished just yet. He barely has time to drink many shields before another enemy is breaking through the top of his box. His opponent actually takes control of the cone, but makes a critical error against one of the smartest players in the game. Avoid at all costs standing directly over the top of your opponent's box, because you will get edited in and end up like this guy, trapped in a box with no chance at all to get out. This clip had two very important lessons. The first lesson is to act quickly whenever you find yourself on low ground. Defending yourself while chopping down the structure is always a safe bet. The second lesson is to look for opportunities to play offensively when you're stuck in a box. There are many ways to do this, and we just explained two effective methods. The last example is a great display of Poach's ability to win games. Poach has a great loadout with a heavy AR and shotgun, SMG, and most importantly, a rocket launcher. This clip was taken from a Winter Royale qualifier match, so these players are very skilled as well. Once we explain all the subtle details of how Poach is able to win this game, you'll have a better understanding of how to close out games for yourself. To start things off, Poch fires a rocket at a player and follows up with AR shots. Even though the rocket didn't accomplish anything, you should always follow up your rocket launcher shot with your AR. Poch manages to slip in a single shot and doesn't overcommit, and he continues to go for high ground. Once he's there, he continues to apply pressure until he's forced off a high ground by the storm. Even though he takes fall damage, he's still trying to maintain high ground until he's forced into a tricky position. Pay close attention to how he masterfully plays out a terrible situation. As Poch jumps off the house, he fires a rocket at the floor. You might think that this was a terrible mistake, but you missed an important detail. Poch saw that a wall just broke, so he knows that a player is right there. Although this rocket didn't land, he could have eliminated someone. You need to use every single piece of information to win games, so start looking and listening. Let's look at Poch's positioning. The three players are in a triangle formation with Poch being at the tip, so you might be thinking, okay, great, why does this matter? When these two players are moving out of the storm in this direction, what do you see? That's right, they see Poch. Positioning is everything during moving circles. Despite being double teamed for a moment, Poch turtles at the exact right moment, and now the last two players are fighting each other. Instead of drinking shields, he goes for positioning and pressure. He's now in complete control of the situation. He counterbills his opponent, and instead of editing and going for the 50-50 play, he goes for the 100% win. At this point, Poch has his opponent sandwiched between himself and the storm, plus he has a rocket launcher. He makes the exact same rocket play we talked about earlier when he was on top of the house, and he secures the victory royale. There are two takeaways from this clip that you need to carry with you into your own games. The first takeaway is to use every single piece of knowledge that's available to make the absolute best play. In a top three situation with the storm closing in, Poch paid attention to something as simple as a wall breaking to secure a win without putting himself in danger. The second takeaway is that positioning is the first step to success when the circle starts moving. You always want to be the player on the outside looking in. If you don't get good positioning, then turtle and wait for the circle to move.
Poch is at the point where he doesn't even have to celebrate wins anymore. This guy is just amazing. This was just a small example of what Poch can do. This guy has killer instincts, just like any great athlete. You guys are now one step closer to playing at that level as well. Let us know which pro player you want us to analyze next. Maybe one of his teammates, Vivid or Chap. Hey, leave it in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.